If you're a fan of Aussie country music, chances are you've heard of our next guest. James Blundell burst onto the Australian music scene in 1987 as a 23-year-old after winning the infamous Star Maker Talent Quest. Since then, he's won a whole heap of Golden Guitar Awards, an ARIA and even an APRA for his hit Way Out West, which he covered with fellow country star James Rain. Four years on and not looking any different. 14 albums later, James has just released his latest single, Sideways, and it's our pleasure to have James in the studio this morning. It's That's so great. Good to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Lovely to meet you.
Fantastic. Yeah, yeah. This is such a treat.
You do the intros. We go way back.
Yeah, yeah.
Way
100%.
Back. But in a good way. Mm. And I've been there many times when you've been up on stage winning those Golden Guitars at Tamworth. You continue to have such an amazing career. What keeps you going in music? What keeps your passion alive?
Every time I work with young artists, I start by saying, if you don't love it, don't do it. Mm. And it's the interaction. It's the alchemy of the creative and then seeing if it relates to people and hopefully enriches their lives. You know, it's a fairly altruistic sort of mission statement, but that's the truth of it, because that's what I got from music as a young listener. It was my international passport, being raised on a property in regional Australia. It showed me what the rest of the world is about.
Oh, good, yeah. And it's been a long time since your last song release. No doubt you've been working on it day and night as well. Why is that taking so long? Which way is the work as an artist?
For the same reason, I've never been a particularly well-focused career artist, and it's sometimes, this is the longest gap, 6 years between this and the last release. But this one came about vicariously through a phone call from a bloke I'd worked with in 2000. We created an album called Deluge. That threw me into a relationship with a bloke who owns a company called Aussie Legends Hemp that I then ambassadored. And all those circumstances came to him saying, you've got to record this record. And I went to Upper Hudson Valley in New York and recorded with the best players in the world. And it's why? Because all those circumstances had to line up before that took place.
How many songs do you write before you find the one that you want to put out?
That's the perfect question. Writing is a work in progress. I do it backstage in my head all the time. And then you commit them to tape or paper or whatever. And then it comes time to focus on a project and you pick out the ones out of 30 or 40 songs that are part of it. So
Sideways is one. You've nailed it. It's smashing it on country radio. What was the inspo for it?
Very colourful life, Angela. And I went to a very dear friend called Bill Page from Mushroom, organised my co-writing for this session. And he said, would you write with Robert Zimmerman, which is Bob Dylan's real name? And I'm going, oh, yeah. and I waited on the Zoom for Bob to turn up, not at all, but there's a different Robert Zimmerman from Texas. And he's had a very colourful life. And in a co-write, you approach the session by saying, are you working on something? Have you got an idea? As a courtesy, professional courtesy. I was walking to the session, having had a day that went nothing like what I'd planned when I got out of bed. And Robert popped up on screen and said, mate, it's going to steamroll this one. Here's the chorus. What do you think? We'd written the thing in 45 minutes, just throwing into it all the things we'd lived through and observed. So.
How good.
Hits written quickly? Are the best songs written quickly?
I would say 80% yes.
Yeah.
But then the real stayers, there's a song on the album called Morrison's Dog that took me 3 years to get right. So you just don't know. I said to Don Walker, I'd been told he'd written K-San in 15 minutes.
Yeah.
And I said, you're right, then 15 minutes? No, it took like 7 years to finish.
He got this much out.
We talked off camera before about touring through Ireland and stuff and touring the country. Does that inspire you as well? I mean, how excited are you to get back on stage?
Yeah, look, very much so. The hard part now, after 35 years of doing it, the travel is the part that becomes the grind. And we're working, we put an airstrip in at home, and hopefully, if it all works properly, I wind up being able to leave home, go to selected touring areas and then get home again, because we're rebuilding the property, refencing, restocking, putting dams in. So it's incredibly busy, up to including going into our second industrial cannabis trial. So it's like holy moly.
No doubt.
No rest for the truly wicked. That's why I look so well. I haven't been getting into trouble.
And you're leaving the music to us as well, which is fantastic.
Well, if you want to find out more about James's tour, dates and tickets, you can head over to his website, jamesblundell.com.au. But here he is, for the first time on Australian television, with his new single, Sideways.
Day breaks, he takes a sip of something strong. Night falls, he calls old friends just to get along. Most days he'll face a stranger in the mirror. Subtle clues, self-abuse, the mess is getting clearer. Sideways, most days trying to figure which way's up. No doubt, he's out of step and out of touch. Folks say he'll pay for living out of line. A little more than less ordinary, but doing fine, living sideways. Grey dawn, a strange room, a face she can't recall. Lost shoes, same blues, she's seen it all before. Most times she'll find a stranger in the mirror. Subtle clues, self-abuse, the mess is getting clearer. Sideways, most days, trying to figure which way's up. No doubt, she's out of step and out of touch. Folks say she'll pay for living out of line. A little more than less ordinary, but doing fine. Some say they're living rough, way too close to dangerous. The mirror smiles and works on trust. But gold lies where the water's deep and lovers never run from heat. They recognize the devil in themselves. Yeah. Sideways, most days trying to figure which way's up. No doubt they're out of step and out of touch. Folks say they'll pay for living out of line. A little more than less ordinary, but doing fine, living sideways.